Hey guys, today we're going to review, unbox, and install a couple of Samsung 850 EVO SSDs. The install is really easy. You just snap the power cable in here like this, and then you take the data cable and you bring it right alongside and you snap that in here like this. And I'll walk through a step-by-step installation into the NZXT S340 case in about a minute. But I'd like to take a little time to review one of the major goals of this budget rebuild. If you remember, we started off with an old HP 1287C that had a SATA II Hitachi as its boot drive. If you look at the crystal disk mark numbers on your left, you'll see that the Hitachi's sequential read and write speeds are right around 130 megabytes per second. You should also notice that the 4K reads and writes were about 1 megabyte per second. So one of the major goals of this rebuild is to improve the I.O. And that's important for audio, but it's especially important for video editing. What we did was an inexpensive motherboard upgrade to an ASRock Z77 Extreme 4. And now we're adding this pair of Samsung SSDs. If you take a look at the same metrics for the SSD, you'll see that the sequential read shows an almost 400% improvement. And even more impressive are the 4K numbers. I'm not going to bore you with those, but I'll let you take some time to look at them as I get started with the unboxing. So we have two SSDs, and the plan here is to use one of the SSDs as a boot drive and to use the second one as a fast cache drive. And this is a budget rebuild, so we're not going to let that 2 terabyte Hitachi go to waste. We're going to repurpose that drive as bulk storage. The Samsungs are simple, sleek, attractive drives, and they come packaged with good documentation, and for some reason, they also come with this DVD that we're not even gonna open. What I really love about the S340 case is its modern, minimalistic approach. It is designed from the beginning for SSDs, and it has these wonderfully simple SSD fixtures. The fixtures just snap onto the back of the disc where it's held in place with 4 screws. And once the disc is mounted to the fixture, it's really easy to install. You just plug in the power cable, then you plug in the data cable, exactly like we saw earlier. And once the cables are installed, you just slide the unit onto the tabs in the case. And we'll take a look at that a little closer when we install the second drive. Once the drive is in the case, you just insert and tighten the thumb screw. So notice how the fixture slides into place. The fixture has slots that mate to the tabs sticking up from the basement, and it locks into place when you slide it under the tabs. The installation is really simple, and the steps are as follows. You attach the fixture to the disc, you plug in the power cable, you plug in the data cable, you slide the fixture onto the tab sticking up from the basement, and then you insert and tighten the thumb screw. And that's it. We just made a 400% I/O improvement at a very low cost.